Once upon a time, Gautam Buddha went to a village in search of alms. As he was passing through fields, he saw that some farmers were resting after working hard in their fields. Buddha went there and he asked for alms. One farmer looked at Buddha and said, "Why are you asking alms from me? I am a farmer. I do a lot of labor. I am able to feed myself and my family only after working hard in my fields. I work hard in my fields throughout the year. Why don't you also work in fields? After that, you should eat the crops you have produced. Then you shall also be a farmer like me." After listening to this, Buddha smiled and said, "My dear friend, I am also a farmer just like you." Hearing this, the farmer started laughing and he continued laughing. There were many questions in his laughter. He asked Buddha, "If you are a farmer, then where are your ploughs? Where is your ox? Where are your crops? And where are your fields? What type of crops do you cultivate? I don't see you having anything. Tell me, how can your work be called agriculture? How can you say that you are also a farmer?" Answering this question, Buddha said, "My dear friend, I am a farmer, just like you. Only difference is that mind is my field, and I sow the seeds of faith, devotion, compassion, and patience in the land of my mind. Determination is my ox, which does not turn its back on seeing obstacles in the field of life. Like your plow penetrates deep into earth, similarly, diligence is my plow, which takes me deep into meditation. My farming is harmed by weeds like anger, lust, greed, attachment, and ego. Just as you have a solution to keep your farming free of weeds, I also have a solution in the form of awareness to keep my farming free from these weeds. I also keep this farming free from the grass of useless and negative thoughts, and I keep trying it till the harvest of bliss. In this way, by cultivating the crop of knowledge, I get the yield of joy, peace, and satisfaction. In the end, just as you provide food to the people to eradicate their hunger, in the same way to erase their ignorance, I provide them the nectar of joy, peace, and contentment." Lord Buddha further said, "In reality, everyone in this world is a farmer according to their karma. Whatever karma a man cultivates in his life, he reaps crop for it. If you will sow the seeds of negative thoughts, anger, and lust in your mind, then you will reap crop of sorrow, sadness, and sufferings. And if you will sow seeds of good thoughts, faith, and patience in your mind, you will reap the crop of joy, bliss, and peace." Hearing this knowledge from Gautam Buddha, the farmer fell at the feet of Buddha and begged forgiveness. The farmer came under the shelter of Buddha and became his disciple. In our lives, we see that we all are also farmers. Some cultivates the seeds of anger and some cultivates the seed of lust. Some cultivates the seed of greed and some cultivates the seed of ego and attachment. Whatever seeds we cultivate, we reap crop for it, but we have forgot to cultivate our mind the way Buddha taught us. If we can also sow the seeds of faith, good thoughts, and patience in the land of our mind, then we will also be able to reap the crop of joy, peace, and contentment. This is Words of Wisdom, Inspirational Stories. Thanks for watching.